transparent to photography. In September 1939, two French photographers were traveling to take pictures of Himalayas. Swami Rama paid them to take some pictures of his master. He led them over a narrow bridge across the Ganges to a small hut where they were living for 15 days. When the master saw the photographers, he looked at him and said, "You are a bad boy. Why must you be so obstinate? They will have nothing." Swami didn't understand at that time. The photographers each took a roll of pictures with their separate cameras. Inserting two new rolls, they asked him to sit next to his master so they could take some pictures of them together. In all, four rolls of pictures were taken with two separate cameras from 3 o'clock to 5:30 in the afternoon. After taking a few more pictures of the mountains, the photographers left for Delhi. When the pictures were developed and returned, Swami could not believe the results. Everything around where the master had been sitting appeared in the pictures, but his master's image did not appear at all. We have seen such incidents in the book by Swami Yogananda also. Healing of
there
patient.
Are no photographs
Swami
for
Rama
his Babaji.
Says the following
Many
about the healing
tried,
power.
But nothing
the power
in the
of self healing is buried in the tomb of every human life. By uncovering the potentials of that power, one can heal oneself. A completely selfless man of God can heal anyone. The highest of all healings is to attain freedom from all miseries. The following example shows how a simple touch can heal anyone from any kind of diseases. This is nothing but pure yogic power. Everything is done by our soul. This example will also show how all things come into play simultaneously to give you a success in your mission. The master said to Swami Rama, "Take the bus to the Haridwar railroad station. You'll get a ticket and from there go to Kanpur. Dr. Mitra is bedridden and is constantly remembering me. He is having a brain hemorrhage and is bleeding out of his right nostril, but his wife will not allow him to go to the hospital. His brother-in-law, Dr. Basu, knows that it is a hemorrhage, but there are no facilities there to perform brain surgery. Swami, what shall I do? Master, just give him a love pat on the cheek. Don't consider yourself a healer. Think that you are an instrument and go there, for I have promised him and his wife that we will always help them. Go as quickly as you can." The Swami came down to the bus route. The bus came and picked him up free of charge. People always help Swamis when they see them. At the railroad station, the Swami wanted to sell his watch to buy a ticket. But a man approached him and gave one of his tickets, saying his son did not come and you travel with his ticket. In the train, Swami met a lady, a close relative of Dr. Mitra. She heard about the Swami and his master from Dr. Mitra. She gave food to Swami and they traveled together all night to Kanpur. Outside the station, Swami met a person who knew him very well. He was waiting with his car to pick up a person from the station. But the person missed the train at the origin in Delhi and never came. He took Swami to Dr. Mitra's house. The book then continues with the following. "When we reached there, I knocked on the door and entered to find three doctors examining Dr. Mitra. Mrs. Mitra was delighted to see me and said, 'Now that you have come, I hand over my husband to you.' This is called Indian blind faith in sadhus, yogis. I said, 'I am not a healer. I have just come to see him.' I went over to Dr. Mitra's bed, but he was not allowed to sit up because of the bleeding from his nostril. When he saw me, he asked, 'How is my master?' I gave him the gentle pat on his right cheek. After a few minutes, there was no more bleeding. One of the doctors explained that the slap which I had given him on the cheek closed the opening in the blood vessel and that it was now sealed. I did not know what I had done, but I followed my master's instructions. Dr. Mitra's sudden recovery quickly became the talk of the town, and hundreds of patients started searching for me. So I left the city later that day and reached Haridwar the next morning. Ability to heal a person is considered as a fundamental responsibility of a yogi. This is how a yogi serves the society, besides giving true knowledge from the Vedas. In the same way, it may be said that if a person cannot heal a sick person, then that person is not a yogi. Along the same line, a yogi himself cannot be sick at any time. If a yogi cannot heal himself, then how can he heal others? Thus, yogis do not practice renunciation. They are intimately linked with the society as guru, as healer, and as messenger of God, propagating the true and eternal knowledge of Vedas. Resurrection of Bengali Baba. Swami Rama's master, Bengali Baba, told him in 1945 that he wants to cast off his body. Then Swami said, "The scripture says it is not desirable to leave a foolish student." Then the master agreed to live. But in 1954, while taking bath in Ganges, Swami thought it was not good to hold the master in his body. The master immediately found it and called everybody and told them he would cast off the body now. He asked the five disciples what they want from him. Swami Rama said, "I want you to be with me whenever I need you." The master agreed. Then master sat in an accomplished pose, closed his eyes, gently muttered the sound Om, and became lifeless. All five students carried the body for 2 days, and then decided to bury the body in a pit 6 feet deep in the snow-covered Himalayas at about 16,000 feet high, in a place from where they could see his master's cave. They laid the body inside the pit. But then all of them were paralyzed and could not move and cover the body. Then from behind the tree, the master said, "Do you need help? Do you need me in the body or without the body?" The students said, "They want him in the body." The master came back and got out of the pit. He said, "It was too bad that you still needed me in the body." Thus we can see that it is a simple matter for an accomplished yogi to leave a body and orient to the old dead body or any other dead body. In this way, it is a very simple matter to extend the life to any number of years, as long as the yogi wants it or destiny allows. Physical transportation. Swami Rama took lessons from his grandmaster, the master of his master, who lived near Lhasa in Tibet, 7,000 feet above sea level. Swami Rama took lessons from him for 2.5 months. One day he was thinking it would be nice if he could write down his knowledge and experiences in his diary. Swami writes, "My grandmaster smiled and beckoned me to come to him. He said, 'I can get your diary for you. Do you need it?' Such a possibility was not a great miracle for me anymore, for I had experienced such things before," Swami wrote. I casually replied, "Yes, and a few pencils too." I had left my diary in India at a sanatorium called Bhavali near the Nainital Hills in North India. Suddenly 3 pencils and my diary, which was quite large, containing 475 pages, were before me. I was pleased but not especially surprised. I told him that I preferred him to give me something spiritual. We can see that mind reading and physical transportation of objects from one place to another is no problem for any yogi. The existence of such powers shows that there are some fundamental laws of nature that our modern technology or science or math has yet to discover. But these techniques can be mastered by anyone by yogic meditation.